Now, we're going to say here, when it comes to nuclear reactions, we can thank the British physicist, Ernest Rutherford, who really did a lot of experiments with nuclear reactions. His contribution to nuclear chemistry was so great that they actually named element 104 after him. Element 104 is called rutherfordium. So it's kind of homage to all the work that he's done in terms of this field. Now, Rutherford basically broke down nuclear reactions into three major types of categories. We have our alpha decay. And you may hear, instead of alpha decay, you may hear alpha emission. We also have beta decay, which you may also hear as beta emission. And then finally, we have gamma emission. You tend to just hear it as gamma emission. You usually don't hear the term gamma decay. Now, what does the word decay or emit mean? Well, that means that the radioactive particle will be a product. So remember, if you hear the word decay or emit or emission, that means that the radioactive particle involved in all these reactions will be a product. Now, the opposite of decay or emitting would be the word capture. So capture would be the complete opposite. Capture would mean that the radioactive particle involved in each of these types of nuclear reactions would be a reactant. So in alpha decay, we emit an alpha particle. In beta decay, we emit a beta particle. In gamma emission, we emit a gamma particle. These particles are what cause our elements to go from one type to another type. And what you have to remember is when they say decay or emission, they're saying that this alpha particle, beta particle, or gamma particle will be a product. But if you hear the term capture or even absorption, then that means that the alpha particle, the beta particle, and the gamma particle will be reactants. And this has a profound difference on what exactly your products will be, because you'll be emitting or decaying these particles along with a whole new element with it. So the farther into this chapter we go, we'll learn that beyond these three, we also have positron emissions as well as electron capture. Those will come after we learn these first three major types. So just remember, in a regular chemical reaction, we start out with, let's say, carbon, we end with carbon. But in a nuclear reaction, we're emitting or capturing radioactive particles, and as a result, that's going to change the identity of my element. You could start out with calcium and end up with something completely different, like argon.